Hi guys, and welcome back to another mega tutorial. This one is going to be another big one. Today we're going to be learning how to build the Tegetthoff-Class battleship. So this is actually, this one is based off the SMS Szent István, which is in English, Saint Stephen. So it's the kind of English equivalent of the name. So it's mainly built off this one, which was actually sunk. So it was used by the Austro-Hungarian Navy. It's a pretty cool and big ship. It's definitely different from the kind of English style. The bridge is really bare, which is actually probably... You don't really want to have everything so built up. So you've got this kind of strange bridge section here, and you've got this very armoured bit which goes over the guns, but it's mainly just big guns. So this ship is 155 blocks long, 53 tall, and it's 33 wide. So it's a pretty big ship. It's a really cool build. So I'm just going to fly over and talk to you guys about kind of how it's going to be laid out. So it's going to be like my other tutorials. It's going to be a layer by layer tutorial. I just find that this is the easiest way to teach them. And also it means that when I'm saying the layers, you can actually take a break. And you can find the layer pretty easily on the video. As I state on the beginning of each section, which layer it is. If you do want to use this build in any of your worlds or server, then you are completely free to do so, as long as you give me credit for the design itself. It's going to be a pretty long build, so you might want to build this on a server with friends, but you can quite easily do it by yourself. Just make sure that you take breaks, otherwise you will end up going a little bit crazy, as I did as I was building this one. It took me about 2 days to build this one in total, so it was one of my longer builds. Usually I do them in, you know, one setting up about 6 hours for a big ship, but this one did take me quite a while because I wanted to get the detail like pretty good on it. So as you can see, I'm still going on it. It is huge. It's a fun build. Just make sure that you credit me. Just say designed by Lord Dacker. If you put it on a server, just make sure that there's a sign not hidden within the ship. You know, just put it, you know, somewhere like on the bridge or something like that, because people do go onto the bridge and have a look around. So yeah, there's not too much to it. I'm going to give a couple of designs for these side guns because I'm not too happy with them, the actual secondary guns that are kind of built into the side and also on these side bits. So I'm going to try and come up with another way, like before I get to that section on the tutorial, which is going to still be for me at least 3 hours below the water probably. So I should be able to give you a couple of ideas for different guns and things like that. But yeah, make sure you enjoy this one. Enjoy yourselves on this one, guys. It is going to be a really fun build, and it's a completely different kind of battleship. I haven't really seen anything. I haven't seen this ship on the internet yet at all. So it might be a first, and it might be a first that you kind of going to be building. It's also going to be my first ever battleship tutorial. So if you guys do have any ideas for other ones, then you know, post them in the links, post them in the comments, like anywhere pretty much, and I'll pick them up. There will be a part 2 to this tutorial doing basic interior. I mean, just look at the size of the actual underneath the hull. There's no way that I think I can, you know, complete the entire interior. And it will probably be a couple of days after. It'll just be to kind of give an idea. I try and get my tutorials done for the Saturday, and I try to get the part 2 for the Sunday. But with this one, it's so big that the tutorial is going to take me so much time that actually I'm probably not going to have much time to actually start building the interior, as I haven't got anything at the minute. So anyway, let's get started with this one. Make sure you enjoy yourself, guys, and you know, take your time with it. So let's get started. Okay, so if you are building this underwater, you're going to be 7 blocks underneath the water on the lowest part. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. This is if you want these two parts showing. So if you want a layer of green and a layer of red, you can change these colours if you want. This is as close as I could kind of get. Most of the pictures of this battleship were in black and white, but there are some quite nice models that people have made, and as far as I can tell, this part is green underneath the water, and then there's like a red purplish strip, but I went with red, it just looked a little bit better. So you'll be 7 underwater, and let's get started on this tutorial now. Okay, so find yourself a really nice big space. You just place down 2 blocks, and you're going to go 3 wide, and this is 2. And then you're going to go 5 wide in total. And this is 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm just going to make a box around the outside like this. And then you guys can just fill in this part. All of this will be solid. And you're going to go 7 wide. This will be another 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. and then go out again. And this one's going to be a 6, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then go out again, and this one's going to be a 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Like this, and just create the box. And then go out again. This one's going to be a 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Like that. And then go out again, and there's going to be another 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then just join this up here. And then go out again, and this is going to be 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And then go out one more time. This is going to be the longest section. This will be 41. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41. And then do that on the other side and make a box. Okay, and then you're going to come in this time and you're going to go 13. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Okay, then come in again and go 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, and then what you're going to do is you're going to come in here and you're just going to have 2 showing here. So let's build up this part here. Just like that, so you've got 2 showing. Then you're going to have another 2 showing as well. So you just leave these 2 showing here. It's kind of difficult, this part. So you got these 2 here, and they got another 2 you're going to have for this part, so then you're just going to have a 5 in the middle here. Then you're going to have a 3, and then there's just going to be 2 on the end. So this end section is a bit more difficult. I'll just kind of fly over it so you can kind of just try and see. And then all you need to do is fill in all of these boxes that I've just left. Fill in all of those sections, and we are done with layer number 1. It is already a big one, guys. So I'll catch you in a sec. Okay, so once you've filled in this kind of massive section, come to the front. You're just going to come forwards and add 3 blocks. And joining onto one of these, you're going to go back by 3. So 1, 2, and 3. And joining onto 1, do another 3. Then what you're going to do is you're just going to outline the ship itself. Just like this. And basically, go back on the long section here, the long 41, and do that on both sides, and I'll get back to you guys. Okay, so once you've got both of those sections done, come to the back. This one's exactly the same as well going in. Just like this. And the next one's slightly different. So just bring it up to the same level on both of these sides. Okay, and once you've got both of those bits, just add one block onto each of them. Then what we're going to do is there's going to be one joining here, and then you're going to come forward, so you've got 2, and they got 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, and then finally at the end you've just got 2. It's really, really easy to do. You just remember that this one, basically what you're doing is just covering up the hole, and it goes kind of backwards. It's long, it's too long in total on all of these sections. So you've just got a load of sets of 2. So hopefully you guys don't get stuck with that one. So that concludes layer number 2 with the 2s on the end. So let's get to layer number 3. Okay, so we're now on layer number 3. So what we're going to do is come to the front, and then we're going to add 3 blocks, just like that. And then all we're going to do is outline what we did on the last layer. Exactly the same, pretty much, as we did before. Go all the way down this long bit, and I'll get back to you guys. Okay, so once you brought both of those back on the long section, you're going to do the same on this one. It just comes in exactly the same, just outlining the last layer. Then this one, you're just going to come right up to that last bit here and then add 2 blocks. And that's going to be 4 behind this, and now it's going to be 3. So you've got 3s going all the way up, just like this. Now, I didn't actually make it so that layer 3 actually had this, but it does. Then on the end, all you're going to do is place one in the middle here and just add 2 blocks, so you've got another 3. I'll do it on the other side as well. It's pretty easy. This is the only tricky bit about the bottom. Most of the bottom of the underwater parts of my ship, so don't spend too much kind of time on them. And then here, just add 2, mainly because, you know, you're underneath the water, you can't see it most of the time. So then you're going to do your 4 here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 3s, 1, 2, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, and you can see the pattern, 3. So there you go, that concludes layer number 3 with all the 3s on it. Done, let's do the next one. Okay, so we're now on layer number 4. So come to the front and add 2 blocks just to the front, and now all you're going to do is outline again. So do exactly the same as we've been doing on the last few layers. This bottom part is way more simple than I was actually expecting it to be. So just outline all of this, get to the long section, and I'll catch you guys again. Okay guys, I've just got one thing to change here. So this block where you've got this 4 that I did on the last layer, you just need to take one block off. It's an extra block that I put in, and it's just confused the hell out of me for the last 20 minutes. I've been flying forwards and backwards trying to figure out what the hell went wrong. So I'm actually just going to cut back this section. I'll start again from that point. Sorry about this, guys. So yeah, just cut off those 2 bits there, and we'll get back onto this layer. Okay, so once you come to the back of this part and you've made your change on there, just come on this one. This one's just going to outline perfectly fine. And this one comes over as well. This, place an extra 2 blocks on. There you go, 3, 3, 3. Then have your iron block behind here. And this one's going to be a total 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We'll do all the props and things in a second. They got another 3 threes, so 1, 2, and 3. And then you're going to put in another iron block, and it's going to be 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'll do the same on the other side. So like this. So this one's just normal outlining, just like this. Come out again. Like this. Add 2 blocks, then go 3, 3, 3. Put in your iron block, this will be 7 in total. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You got 3, 3, 3. Another 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And just on the inside, you've got 3 on these sides. And you've just got a 2. So you've got 1 that connects in here, and then just comes forwards by 1. And that's it. So for your propellers themselves, just place 2 gold blocks on the front of both of these, like this. And then the propellers are just going to be this really simple design that I've borrowed from Jag Funder's tutorials and his builds. It's really easy. So there's 4 props on this one in total, so it's got quite a lot of them. Just like this. There. And then the last one. Just like that. And now we'll just build the rudders. Okay, for the rudders, what you're going to do is, off this block here, come forwards, and it's just going to be right next to this one here, just on the outside, so you're going to the outside of the ship. Put down 3 blocks, there's going to be 3 blocks underneath as well, and there's going to be 2, just like this. You can make it one bigger if you want, and actually have it like this. If you want to, it's up to you. I just think it looks a little bit better if it's actually raised from the kind of bottom. So then on the other side again, find this gold block, go out to the outside of the ship, do 3 blocks, then 3 blocks, and a 2. And that completes layer number 4. You're doing really well, guys. We're probably about halfway underneath the water. It's taken me absolutely ages. But keep on going. Okay, so we're now on layer number 5. So come to the front, come forwards by 1, like this. Then you have 2 of these ones that are overhanging. It's going to be 5 in total, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. All of these ones going right back to the last long one, are just straight on top. So I'll show you exactly where to stop. So keep on putting all of these just on top of the last layer, exactly the same. And then do it all the way to this last one here. So you're going to lay these on top like this. Do that on both sides, and I'll get back to you guys. Okay, so once you've brought both of those back on each side, you're going to add 1 block. So you might as well do it on the other side at the same time. Just add an extra block. So it's only got 1 extra block on this long run. So it's just like this. Then you're going to go 1, 1, and 1. You got a 2, 2, 1, 1, and a 1. So I'll do the same on the other side. So you got 1, 1, without placing a million blocks, 1, 1, 1, 2 twos. So you got 2, 2, 1, and then in this gap here, a 1. And that finishes off layer number 5. No, it doesn't. And then come around to the back, I always forget these rudders, just add an extra 3 blocks onto these rudders here. And now you're done with layer number 5. Okay, so we're on to layer number 6 now. So come forwards again, you're going to go forwards by 1 block. And then again, you're going to have an overhang, so this is going to be 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These, there's going to be 3 of these, which are just 2, so you've got 2, 2, and 2, just laying straight on top. And you should have a gap behind this one. This one's actually going to be a 4, so 1, 2, 3, 4. Again, you got a gap, another 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then you got 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So all this is doing is just shaping it a little bit better. I'll show you guys kind of another way of that I actually shape these, but if I have a look at the one over here, I'll just show you what I'm actually doing. It makes it a little bit smoother, so you get these kind of lines going here. It's still got a couple of straight lines, but it does smooth it out just a little bit, and since it's underwater, it doesn't matter too much, but I still end up putting it in. So then behind this 7, what you're going to do is you're just going to go straight on top, exactly the same as we did last time. Go all the way to that long last stretch there. Do that on both sides, and I'll show you what to go, and I'll show you guys what to do. Okay, so once you've brought both of those back on each side, you're just going to do exactly the same as we did last time. Just add one block onto each of them. I'll build it on this side because it's a bit easier. So you've got 1, 1, 1, 2. So 1, 1, 1, 2, 2. You got 1, 1, and then this one comes forwards by 2, like this. So I'll do the same on the other side, as I kind of went a bit nuts there. So 1, 1, 1, yep, 2, 2, 1, 1, 1, like that. So that's what you should have for that kind of main body, and then we're going to go to the rudders. Build this up by 3 again, just like this. And you're just going to add a block on kind of each of the faces that are showing. So on the back, you're going to add 1. On the side, you're going to add 3, 1 on the front, 1 on the other side as well, 3 on the side, 1 on the back, 3 on the side, 1 on the front, like that, and that finishes off layer number 6. Okay, so we're on layer number 7, you're doing really well, guys. We've got just this layer and another layer of green, and we're onto the red layer, and then onto the actual ship itself. So what you're going to do is you're going to place a block right on the front, and this time you're going to go backwards, so it's a bit different. The actual ship itself kind of goes, it's got a very strange shape at the front, as you can see here, so it kind of goes out and then comes back in. So this is all we're building now. So you've got those 2. Then you've got 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then you've got 3 sets of 2, so you've got, they're overhanging by 1 each time, so 2, 2, and 2. 2 sets of 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then another 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So you're just doing this kind of step pattern, like this. Then you've got an 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And then these are going to lay exactly on top, just as we've been doing with the last layer, and go right down to that kind of, that long bit we've doing, just go set straight on top this time with that layer. So do that on both sides, and I'll get back to you. Okay, so once you've brought both of those back, we're actually going to stop this layer now, so we're not going to go out by 1. So what you're going to do is place a block here and come out. So you've got 2 in total on this one. You're then going to build an L shape, so I'll show you where it is. So it's kind of coming out by 1. There's going to be a block on top of this one, and then it comes across here, like this. I'm pretty sure that this block is actually a misplace, but I'm going to leave it in, otherwise it might get confusing for me when I'm teaching the tutorial. So, but I'm pretty sure that this block, you don't need it, but I'm just put it in there. Then you've got a 4, so you're going to come out this way by 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So we're now building the bit that goes over the rudders themselves and connects in. So you got this, so you got 2, an L kind of shape that we probably don't need, and a 4. And you're going to have a 3, 1, 2, and 3, then a 1. And then you're going to have 2 coming across the back like this, so it just kind of connects into this part. Then you're going to come across the back by 3, 1, 2, 3. So I'll do it on the other side because it's a bit weird. So you got this 2 coming across here like this. Then you have your L, which you probably don't need. And then you have a 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And you're going to have a 3, 1, 2, and 3, then a 1, then a 2. And then all you're going to do is just come over and fill in these gaps like this. And do that all the way across. All I did is mainly over these parts, I just filled them in solid because there's no real point. I mean, you could have them cut out, say, later on if you have this section and it's got, say, bathrooms or toilets in it, you can actually have them for those, or if you have a shower, you can have it dip down a bit. So just fill this in, and then you're done with layer number 7. Okay, so we're on layer number 8, which is the last of the green wool, so you should, that last layer should have been just on the side of the water, and then this one is just above it, if you're doing it exactly the same way as me anyway. So you come to the front, place a block one block back. So you've got these two blocks kind of at the front. You got one block here, and you're going to go back by one. And you got two, 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 and two. So there should be five in total. So go one, two, three, four, and five in the twos. You got three, one, two, three. Then you got four, one, two, three, and four. And then another four, one, two, three, and four. And then what you're going to do is you're now going to outline the ship. So we're going out again. So just do this on the kind of major run. I'll show you where to kind of go back to. So go all the way down here. And then do it onto this kind of layer here, not this last layer. There's a slight difference on this last layer where it starts to go around. So just get on both sides, just go right up to this layer like this. And then I'll get back to you once you've done that on both sides. I'll get back to you on this part and show you what's kind of different on this last run. Okay, so once you've brought both of those back and not done this one, so this one shouldn't be outlined at all. What you're going to do is come to the back of this part, leave one block, then place a block directly on top. And this is going to be six long in total, sorry. One, two, three, four, five, and six. So we're rounding off these parts as well, because this back part as well has a bit of a weird thing. And then what you're going to do is you're just going to outline here. So one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and ten. So this outline part should be a ten, and then it starts to go in. So I'll just do it on the other side as well. So leave one block, and you've got six. One, two, three, four, five, and six. And this part should be a 10 in total, outlining 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10, like that. And I'll just do it on this side because I've kind of been teaching on this side, it makes it a little bit easier. And you're going to have a 5, so 1, 2, 3, so you come into this back part here, so you got this 3 here, and 4, and 5. Then you have a 4, so 1, 2, 3, and 4. You got 3, 1, 2, 3. You got 3 ones, 1, two, three ones, so one, two, three, like that. They got two, which are now switching direction around the back to round it off, like this. Then you got three, one, two, and three. I'll do the same on the other side as well. So you got these two have got blocks on them. There's gonna be one around the back. It's a bit awkward, I know. One, two, three, four, and five. So this is a five here. Then a four, one, two, three, four, then a three, one, two, and three. You got three ones, one, two and three, two that goes this way, and you got the three across the back. Now all you're going to do, like you did on the last layer, is just come around the back of these and just put in a block just on the back part of them, and it'll just finish up that layer, and you're done with number eight. So well done, guys. Okay, so we're now on layer number nine. So this is actually the red layer, so you're done with the green wall, so throw that away, done. You won't need it again. So then this layer is really, really easy. You're just going to lay on top exactly the same as you did on the last layer, just go straight over the top. And I'll show you where it does start to get different, so keep on bringing these all the way down the main kind of length of the ship. And there should be a 3 at the end, so you've got these. And this is the 3 here, 1, 2, and 3. So just lay all these ones on top, not on these kind of side parts, just do the outline of it, so you've still got this green on the inside. It's just going around the outside of the ship until you get to this 3 here. And the back is a little bit different, so do that on both sides, and I'll get back to you. Okay, so once you've done all that on both sides, and you've got these threes here, what we're going to do is place a block on this one, come forward, so it's two, like that. So it's just got this one overhang. You've got two ones, one, another one, and then a two, and then a three. So basically what you're doing is just outlining it. So you've just got this two here after this three, one, one, and two. So you're just kind of finishing off the back. All this does is it just continues this kind of slope that's at the back of it going upwards. So now we're also done with the red wall, so throw that one away, and we're onto either light grey. For most of you guys that are playing this, you're probably using light grey unless you're using Sphax, which I think the iron blocks, especially with connected textures, look amazing, which I don't have on at the minute, or iron blocks. So it's up to you if you want to use light grey wool or iron blocks. And we're finally onto the kind of next layer. So well done, guys. Okay, so we're now onto the next layer. So this one is just going to come in by one block. And then you've got two. It's basically going to sit exactly the same on the top of the last layer. Build this up by three in total on pretty much all of it. That is different parts, so I'll actually probably just tell you guys to build this up by free on every single part, just building straight on top, and then I'll tell you where to kind of cut out for these parts. There's also a bit on the back, but the main hole is actually just going straight up like this. So build that all up by free around the entire outside on top of the red layer, and I'll show you what to change on it. Okay, so once you've built all of those walls up by free, what you're going to do is cut off where you've got these twos, just cut off two of those blocks. That's going to be one block behind it like that, and that's all you needed to change for the front part, and then it starts working its way back up again, and we'll get onto the back. Okay, so when you're on the back, just knock out these three on the back here, and just one on one of these side parts here, and then what you're going to do is come forward by one like this, and then you've got three across the back. This is the kind of first change. We'll go on to the next one. And then the next part, what you're going to do is, on this block here, what you're going to do is place a block here. You can take off this top as well, actually. You've got this one here, so you got one. Well, you got this two, actually. Two going across here, on top of that one. And you got a one, and then a three. So it's just outlining this part here. So I'll just give you an aerial shot. So you got this two, one, three, like that. And then we've just got one more to do. Okay, so the last bit. What you're going to do is, well, you've got these two, one, bits that are going up by one. Just take off this side part here and add one like this. So you got this two here. Then this one's just going to come out by one like this. The same on the other side as well. So take off this part here when you got these two ones. Add a block here. You have one coming in like this. Then you have a two on each side. And then a one. Then three again. So it's a little bit different, this back part. So you've got. I'll just try and give you guys a couple more shots of it, like this. So the bits that we've changed are these bits here. So you got this 2, 1, 2, 1, 3. And the same on the other side as well. So you got these two sets of 2 here after this 3 here. Hopefully that bit's not too complicated for you guys. And we'll get on to the next part. So that's finishes up layer 10 to 12, actually. So let's go, let's do this. Okay, so now we're on to layers 13 to 15, which is the last kind of set of grey walls. So what I'm going to do to make this one easier is I'm just going to place down one block, and then what you're going to do is you're just going to add two blocks onto each of these, so it's going to be three high in total. So when I just kind of do this with those blocks, you're just going to add an extra two on top, because most of it is exactly kind of that way. There's a tiny little bit of difference at the back, so I'll just kind of tell you how to do it the fast way, and then I'll do what I did at the back and just chip out blocks like that. So what we're going to do is come to the front. It's going to place down one block. This again will be three high. You got one, then two, 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 and then a three, four, and four. So most of this front section like this is basically on top. There is a difference when you get to this six here. What you're actually going to do is go back by 30 blocks. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. So it should get to 30 blocks like that. And then what you're going to do after this is come here and go 3. So you've got 1, 2, 3. Then you're going to switch directions, come across sideways. This is going to be 2, so it'll be 1 short of the actual hole itself. Then you're going to have an 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So it should be 3 blocks kind of behind this part here. Now 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then what you're going to do is you're going to come in here and you're going to go back by 3. And then after you've got these 3, all these kind of little bits here are actually for where the side guns are going to go. So what I'll do is I'll build the entire kind of side deck and then tell you how to do these. So you've got a gun here, you've got a gun here. So after this, you've got 7 and 3, then you're going to have 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And come in, another 3, 1, 2, 3, another 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Come in again, do a 3 like this. And I believe there's a 5 on this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Yep. So you got 5 there. Then you got a 2 here coming inwards. So you're doing the same kind of thing as you did on the front, creating these kind of curves on it. And then you got a 3, 1, 2, and 3 like this. So you're just creating that part there. And then coming back in again, you're going to have 33 this time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33. So it should just come straight over this kind of 5 that you've got here. So it just goes in here like this and goes around. And then what you're going to do is you're going to have a 4, 3, 2, to 1-1, and then when you come to the back here, you're going to come in and come in on both of these sides like this. So you've got this part sticking out, and then you've got these two sides. What I did for this part is I used iron bars. I believe I used spruce wood for the actual floor, but it depends what you want to use for your deck. And just on this, I just built up a small kind of back part like this. And on these parts here, I just wove around a couple of bars. I might have done it like that, I'm not too sure. Yep, so that's just how I wove those around here. I just checked, so you just weave them around like this. You're going to have one across the back as well. And then you'll have, of course, one on the other side. So this just creates this back part here. Like this. So when you build it up by three, I'll tell you where to do these slight different block changes, but just build every single little bit that we've done so far, build it on the other side as well, build it up by three, and I'll get back to you guys. Okay, so once you've built all of that part up and done it on both sides and built it up by three, what you're going to do is come around the back, and all you're going to do is just put in a block diagonally across this part. This part will be joined as well. So this is just going to build up for the upper deck, so you get this kind of back viewing part here. What you can then do around these side parts as well, what I did is I put in grey wool for this part. So you can put in your grey wool just on the kind of inside parts of these. And of course there's four of these in total, so fill those ones in as well. What you can also do, what I'll also show you how to do, is these side parts here where you've got these kind of indentations for the guns. They're only actually two deep, so what you're going to do is you're going to take out the back three, then come across, so you're creating these kind of parts here. So come around and do that on all of those parts. So you've got the kind of three main ones in the middle. And then for this one here as well, what you're going to do is this part here. So you've got these three here I've just cut out here. And you've got this one here. This is the front of the ship. So you've got this one here. This is just going to come over by three as well. So it's basically in line with the rest of the ship going up. And this part was just cut out for the gun itself. And then what you're going to do while you're at the front, there's one more gun here. What you're going to do is on this three that you've got, you're just going to cut out two of them and go over like this. So you get this part, and again, of course, filling your deck with grey wool on this part. And I believe there's one more at the back that I have just skipped over, but it's exactly the same as the front bit that comes in. So you're just going to take off these two parts and put in two blocks like this. Fill in these side parts with grey wool. What you can also do while you're here as well is fill in the deck. I use spruce wood because it looks a bit darker, but I'm not too sure what the actual colour of the deck is, if you want to use oak wood planks or spruce wood planks. Basically choose whatever you kind of want wood wise for the deck itself. Fill in all of this part here, fill in all of that, fill in the grey parts on the sides, and then what we'll do is we'll build up these guns, we'll build up these ramps on the side. I'll tell you where to put the windows as well if you want to put those in, and then we're just basically onto this top layer here with the big guns, which are really easy, the smokestacks, the kind of bridge part. So we're really getting there, guys, so let's get to it. So fill in this and I'll catch you again. Okay, so once you've filled in kind of the bottom floor with the grey and then whatever wood you've chosen, just to get down on these parts, there's a couple of ladders. So on this long stretch, what you're going to do is come in by one block and just put in a ladder here. Do that on all of the four sides. And then what you're going to do around the ship, what I used, I use never brick fence for this. You can use normal fence. What I'm actually going to do is I'm going to use normal fence just to see what it looks like. So all you're going to do is go around the outside, obviously leaving the gap for the ladders. Just come around like this, around the entire outside of the ship. Then what I did is I linked them up going around. And what you can do is switch out the blocks for iron blocks. So do that around the entire ship. I'll show you what to do next. Okay, so once you've gone around the entire kind of perimeter with your fence, on the front and also on the back, just find the forwardmost post and just go up by three. One, two, and three. So just add an extra three blocks at the front and do the same on the back as well. And now what we're going to do is we're going to build the secondary guns, or at least this style of doing the secondary guns. I'm going to have a go at making up another version as well. So if it isn't in this video, that means that my other version was terrible. Okay, so if we build it in this part here, what you're going to do is you're just going to come in the middle of this part, go up by two blocks of cobblestone. I've put two cobblestone slabs on each side. You could use stairs if you wanted to as well. Place your buttons around the outside, just on the two sides, and you're just going to come forwards by three with your stone slab. So these ones are really easy. They are directly in the middle with the two bits on the side. Comes forward by three. You got button and you got your buttons on them. So do that on all of them. I'm going to have a go at coming up with another design for them. If it isn't in this video, it means that they were pretty terrible. So just get those done on all of those. There should be six on each side. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then your sixth one is going to be here. So it's just in that other gap there, just like that. So get that done. Alright, so the other kind of gun style I've come up with is this style. It's a bit different from these ones here. So it's got a bit more shape to it. So I'll just show you how to do one by just cutting one out here. So it'll be the same on all of them. All you need to do is place a cobblestone block in the middle. Put your stairs on each side of them. You then got another stair in the middle. And then an upside down stair here. Then put a cobblestone slab on top here. And then I came forwards with two stone slabs. So it's a pretty easy design. So what you can do is you can just come forwards with your cobblestone slabs. Or you can use these. The reason I use the stone slabs is in my texture pack, it kind of sticks out a little bit. So I've got most of the guns with these, especially the side guns. So that's how I've kind of come up with another version of doing that. So let's go on to the next part. Okay, so we're just going to put in the anchors on the side for this. So find your three here, right at the front. Knock out a block, put in an iron fencer use, then come forwards. This will go down by four in total, so count this one, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Go out on each side like that. You can do the same on the other side as well. Then the next one, all I did is I did exactly the same, but on this two coming forwards, and it only goes up by three and just comes out to the side. It's the kind of best I could do. It's got four anchors on this one. So that's kind of what I came up with, just one that's actually a bit bigger than a smaller one. So do that on the other side, and then we're going to start setting up for this kind of anchor system, and then we'll get on to the big guns. Okay, so coming to the front, what we're going to do is we're just going to set up the markings on this part. So you're just going to switch out right in the middle for grey wool instead of the actual wood. So you're going to go back by 17 in total, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. This will be 3 wide in total for this part. And these are all exactly the same length, so this just goes down to here. So cut out all of this bit. And then put in your grey wool. Okay, once that's filled in, go to one of the sides, and now you're going to do 22. So counting these two here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. So you should be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 blocks kind of past the last one. So it's going to be exactly the same on the other side. So just fill this one in with your grey wool and do it on the other side as well. Alright, so then once you've got these two parts here, you're just going to go on each side of these, just by an extra three blocks. This is just setting up for the actual, the bits that it goes around, I'm not sure what they are, the kind of motory type things. And then go to the outside of the front part again. This is only going to be six this time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Just fill that in, do the same on the other side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Just like this. So that completes the actual, kind of changing out the actual deck for these markings. Alright, so now we're going to just build this bit in the middle. So come into the middle of these parts. You're just going to place a slab on the top of each of these. It's going to become a double slab. And then you're going to leave a block, and then it's going to be a double slab like this. And then in between each of those parts, you're going to have slabs. And then I used a cobblestone wall and put a slab on top like this. It's up to you if you want to do this part or not. If you don't have a cobblestone wall, I can't remember still if it's on the Xbox version or not. Then use like some sort of fence, use whatever fence that you use for this. I mean, I use normal fence for this, which I actually prefer the never brick, but use the opposite type of fence that you've used around the outside, if that makes sense, and we'll get on to the next part. Okay, and then in the middle of these two squares that we've made, I put in my cobblestone wall. Again, switch it out for whatever you have, and put a stone slab on the top. And then just on these three corners, you put down the slabs. So it's basically the chains themselves are going around it, and then they'll be going down into two holes here. Okay, and then what you're going to do is, this last square here, you're just going to cut this out on each side, and then you're going to cut out another one here. And we're just going to create a little platform underneath, goes down. It's just going to create a little step pattern, like this. Now I need to cut somewhere through to get through to the top deck, like this, there we go. So the reason that I'm doing these parts is because you're going to put in your... I used anvils for these parts, but just wrap them around, and then this is where it's going to go down into the actual ship itself. So you have these going around this way, and not that way, this way, like this. Ramvils go down just like this. So it just has those two kind of cut-out parts that go down into the hole itself. Then what you're going to do is, where you've got this big bit here, you're going to put down another two cobblestone walls or whatever block you've got, and just put a stone slab on top. It's really, really easy for this part. And then bring your anvils, or if you don't want to use anvils, what you can also use, I've already got a cobblestone slab, you can also use your like cobblestone slab or something else, like kind of slab-wise, and you can actually bring these around as if they were the chains themselves. I just use anvils because it looks really cool. I borrowed this kind of thing from Jagfunder, so the credit goes to him for this, using the anvils in this way. It does look really cool. Let's bring these back like all the way right to the side of these parts. And if you come to the front, what you're going to do is you're going to count back onto the sides here and count back 1, 2, 3 and 4, and cut out the fourth one, so you've got 3 grey wall on each of these sides. These again are the actual holes that it's supposed to be going down, which kind of line up-ish with these. It doesn't quite work, so you can pull them back a little bit. It's just that this makes it look a little bit fuller at the front. I just came in again and put in these holes here, so you are going to have to punch through the hole to get to this part like this. And then what you're going to do is just bring back your anvils all the way to this hole. So you're actually coming in, when you've got these parts here, it actually kind of comes in to the center and makes it a bit thinner. Comes down like this, and then pop one in the hole. You can actually pop them in sideways if you want to. It's up to you which way you want to kind of do it. And then count back two of these ones here, and they're going to cut out another hole here on each side. And do exactly the same thing we did before. We're just going to come underneath so that the anvils themselves have something to kind of lean on. And when you're cutting through the hole for this next part, be careful because the anvils, of course, do have gravity, so they do fall down. So I usually cut out on that part there. And then with your anvils again, put them in these side parts, which kind of, again, they're roughly lining up. But that pretty much finishes off the actual chain system. So let's get on to the next part. And now what we're going to do is we're going to set up for these big guns. So we're just going to put in the kind of basis of both of these big guns, for the front two anyway, and then we can do the back kind of after we've done these guns. What we'll do is I'll go straight to the back section, because the guns are built pretty much exactly the same on both of these sides, so it'll be quite easy. So what you're going to do is, from the back of these chain section here, leave a one block gap, and you're going to have a 7 wide in total. So just place one block in the middle and then go 3 on each side, just like this, so it'll be just like this, not whatever I just did. So you got it right in line like this, and you're going to have 1, then another 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and a 1, a 7, 1, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and a 1, just like that. So you get this kind of part here, then you're going to leave a 3 block gap, so you got a 3 block gap here. Then you're going to do exactly the same, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and a 1, and a 7, and a 1, a 7, a 1, so just like this. So this is just going to be for the kind of around the actual guns themselves. It's quite kind of square, but it does get more rounded as soon as we get onto that part. And then what you're going to do with these parts is, on each of these kind of corner parts, you're just going to add a cobblestone block. I'm just using the double slabs, because it's just exactly the same, and it just means I'd have to switch out the blocks. So you get this instead. This will be exactly the same on this part as well. It's actually the same on all of the guns, just like this, like that. And then you're going to have 5 with iron blocks behind it, then a 1 and a 5, then a 1 and a 5. You don't have to put the 1 in behind these. I just do because it kind of completes the circle. It makes it a little bit easier in some ways, even though it's not seen. But if you do cut through the actual deck itself to put in some sort of kind of railing system for the actual ammunition, then it makes it easier. So let's get on to the next part for this. And then for the back one, what you're going to do is you're just going to double up these. So just add an extra 2 blocks to them, so they're actually 3 high for the iron. This is for the actual back kind of higher one, like this. So I might as well do kind of both the guns at the same time, because they're exactly the same on this part here. Except for there's a couple extra kind of secondary guns on the top, but they are pretty much exactly the same design. So just do that on that one there. then all you're going to do is you're going to get some stone stairs. These are going to go on top of the kind of layer, if it's the top of this one or it's on this part here. I just wrapped around a load of stairs, wrapping around onto each part, and it just kind of wraps all the way around on each of these sections, just like this. So it can be a little bit fiddly of moving around a lot with these. So I'll just show you how to do the bottom one. And this one here is exactly the same. So let's do this. Wrap around like this. And I'm probably gonna have to change the direction of one of them. This one here. So just do that like that, so it's actually just wrapping around all the way. Do the same on this top part as well. Okay, and then once you've got both of those, what you're gonna do is, well, I'll just build up the bottom one. I'll do kind of both of them. Just gonna come across the top on this. It's gonna be 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this part here is just gonna create an indented part here. So you got 5, then you have a 1, like this. Then you have a 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then you got 2. Then you got 5 across the back, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You got your 2 again, 5, 6 even, 6, like this. And then you got a 1. Then come on the inside and you're just going to fill in these holes like this. So there's no gaps kind of showing. There's quite a lot around the back, like that. Oh, and there as well. So do the same on this part as well. So you got a 5, 2, 3, 4, 5, and a 1, and a 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And you got 2 coming in, 2, and a 5 across the back, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 2, and 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then a 1. And then again, come on the inside, fill in these gaps, just like this, really easy. Especially with the higher one, make sure you fill in the gaps, because the lower one, obviously you can't really see that much, you're going to see like parts of them, but the higher one you can actually see underneath it, especially when you go around the back here. You can definitely see it. Then all you need to do is just build this part up by 2 in total. You don't need to build the inside parts here up by 2, of course. So just building these up like this, 2 high. And then what you'll do on each of these is you'll just fill in this kind of top part with, I use grey wool for this. Just like that. So do the same on the other part as well, and I'll get back to you for actually putting in these guns themselves, the kind of turrets and all the detail on them. Okay, so once you've got these kind of shells of them, what you're going to do is, for the guns themselves, there's going to be 3 guns on each of them. So it's going to cut out this first block and actually cut into the grey wool. And then counting this block here, you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And all of them are 10 long, so you've got 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So it's pretty easy. So you kind of get that. So they've all got this kind of indent by 1 in total. Do the same on the kind of upper ones as well. So just cut into these and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Another 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And another 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Just like that. And then what you're going to do is you're going to get your iron bars out. These are going to go around the back part. You've got the 6 going across here, and the back 3 have got iron bars in them. You're just going to wrap them around the back section itself, kind of connect them all into each other. Just like this. So it's just the back 3. It's exactly the same on the top part as well. Just these 3 here come around the back, go all the way around like this. That's just the third one there. Then you can get out your weighted pressure plate, which is what I used, or you can just use normal pressure plates. I just put them around on the metal parts, or if you're making it out of light grey wool parts. Just like that. Okay, and then what you're going to do is come to the front, and there's these kind of 3 hatches behind the guns themselves, so leave a block of grey here, and then you're just going to put down stone slabs is what I used, and then come to the back part. What I might actually do is I'm just going to destroy a couple of these and redo them in a second. It'll make it a little bit easier to show you guys. So you leave a 1 block gap here. They're going to put down 3 stone stairs, and then you're just going to come forwards by 2 on these with the slabs. So you create this kind of back part. So I'm just going to recount these. And then do the same part on the back. These actual hatches aren't on the kind of higher one, there's actually these secondary guns. I'll show you how to do that in a second. Just put in your stairs 1 block from behind, from the back, and then add 2 slabs onto the front of each of these ones. And then for your secondary guns, which are on top of this, They're going to be in the same kind of position as we actually have these slabs, so you're going to leave one block of grey, then come back. I use stone stairs for this just because it was a bit different. But it's up to you what you want to use, if you want to use, you know, stone or some other sort of thing that you've got, block that you have stairs with as well. Then on top of these, place your stone stairs or whatever you're using. Then on the back as well, you're going to use upside down ones so you get that kind of shape. Then come forwards by two in total, just on the lower part, just like this. So this is the kind of design I came up for the actual, these type of guns, the secondary guns, I guess you could call them. So there we go, so those are the front two turrets. We'll now start setting up for the back two. The back two turrets are exactly the same, just obviously flipped 180 here, but I'll still go through them with you guys so that you know, you're 100% sure on how to do them. So let's get to it. Okay, so now come to the back. What we're actually going to do is we're going to set up these kind of bits that are randomly on the deck. I just kind of came up with this thing. It's roughly based on what I could actually see on the ship itself. Because we're in Minecraft, I changed it a bit to make it look a little bit more interesting. So what you're going to do is you're going to find this three that you've got at the back here. And then count in one, two, one, two, three. And then the fourth block here, you're going to place down one block there. Just like that. We'll do the same on the episode as well. So find this three here. You're going to count back four. One, one, two, three, four. And that's where your block is actually going to be. This will go back by two in total, so it's too long. Like this. And all I did is I put the weighted pressure plates on top. I just went kind of crazy with the buttons. Put them all the way around the sides. So it adds a little bit of depth to these pretty boring kind of shapes. And then we'll get on to the next bit. And then for the next one, what we're going to do is we're going to leave a two-block gap in between these, and we're also going to go towards the outside of the ship. So you've got this two-block gap here, just like that, and they're built in exactly the same way with your kind of pressure plates on top, and you've got your buttons around the sides. The same on the other side. You've got a two-block gap, and it's actually coming out by one block towards the outside of the ship. Pressure plates and buttons around them. Just like this. Now we're going to the big one, and then we're going to set up for these guns. And then we're going to have another two-block gap. So we've got a two-block gap. If you come to the center line, find the middle of it. This is going to be a two-block gap, and then just place down two blocks. This is going to be a total of six blocks in total, like this. So you've got a two-block gap between these two, and this is right in the center of the ship. If you need to find the center of the ship, you've got that fence that kind of is sticking out, so you can kind of line it up quite well. You're going to put stone slabs on the top this time. But exactly the same thing with your buttons, just going around like this. And now we're going to set up for the guns the same way that we did before. They're pretty much the same. I'll just tell you where to place them. Okay, for the back guns, what you're going to do is from this one here, you're going to leave a two-block gap, and you're going to come across. This is going to be your 7-1 again. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 like that. So you've got two extra on each side of this thing here. You got a 1, then a 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, then 1, then 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, then 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Just like this, and then you're going to have your kind of full blocks. I can't place blocks at all. I've been doing this tutorial too long, you can probably tell. So you've got these kind of full blocks in between these parts, like this. Just like that. And then just like the last one, we're going to have a 3-block gap between these, 1, 2, 3. And you got your another 7 again, just like this. Just gonna get rid of those. And then you got 1, then 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 1, not there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and a 1. Put in your blocks in each of those kind of corner parts, like this. Just like that. Then get your iron block or light grey wall block, and you're gonna have your circle 5. 1, and then a 5, then a 1, just like this. 5, 1, 5, 1, same on the kind of higher one as well. Just like this, and then of course this back one is a height of 3 in total. So just add, you know, an extra 2 blocks onto each of these parts, like that. Then get out your stone stairs, and we're going to wrap them around just like we did before. So we're just going to wrap these around like this. Okay, so once you've wrapped your stairs around on both of those parts, what we can do is I'll just do the bottom one first. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, coming across the top on this with your iron blocks or light grey wool. Then you get your 1 and a 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then you're going to have a 2 and a 5 across the back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like this. A 2, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I did too many. I did 7. There we go. And then you go 1. Just like that. So you'll build the same on the other side. I'll just show you how to do one of the bases again, just in case you've forgotten from the front if you had a break. So then just fill in the kind of gaps here so that you've not got any light kind of coming through or showing like that. And just build up the outside by one more layer like this. Just like that. And then fill this in with your grey wool. Like this, really, really easily. Do the same on this part as well. So this, just take this kind of section here up onto this part, and I'll get back to you guys. Okay, and then once you've done that on both of them, on the last three again, use your iron bars around and wrap these around. I'm going to do this before doing the guns this time, as it did make it a lot easier. There we go. So it's just the last three. Same on the front part as front gun as well. Well, it's not the back front gun. The forward most gun towards the back, I guess. I have no idea. Anyway, and then what you're going to do is you're going to put in a one block gap, have your three stairs, and have two slabs like that. It's just this kind of back section. Three of those, two slabs. Just like this. We'll put in our guns now. So you're going to cut in twice and then go 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And that's three of these. Just like this. And then to finish off the forward gun, leave a block of grey and put in your stone slabs like so. And put your weighted pressure plates on the kind of bits that are left showing, just like that. So that finishes off that gun. And that will just finish off this one. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Come straight over. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And another 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Just like this. So you're going to put your pressure plates again over on these parts, and I just need to grab stone brick block. Leave a one block gap, put down three of these. Then you have your stone brick stairs on the kind of upside of them, and then upside down on the back. Then come forwards by two of your stone slabs, just like that. So that finishes off all the big guns on the ship itself. Another thing that I actually did on the side of the big ones, I grabbed a ladder and just right in the middle of this, well, not in the middle, but kind of before this part here, I just put in some ladders. You can put them on these parts as well. Obviously you won't actually be able to get up on it, but, or can you? No, I don't think you can get up on it, but on mine I only put them on the sides here, and it was only on the top part here as well. So you can put those on both of those guns. I'm going to put them on both of them, and we'll get on to the next section. Okay, before I forget, I'm actually going to put in these glass blocks, which are kind of portholes on the side. So we're currently on the back of the ship. So where you got your ladder, leave a one block gap, and you're just going to place down. Then you have two block gap, and then this is basically going to be the pattern that goes down. There's going to be 10 of these. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8. 9 and 10, so that's on that stretch. It'll be the same on the other side, so I won't show you guys that. And there's just two extra in. When you got this 4, I just put one in, not all the way down there. Put one in there, just with a 1 block on the inside, and then on this 3, I put one right in the middle. So do that on the other, do the same on the other side. Then come to the front, we're going to do exactly the same kind of counting wise, but it's going to be 9 in total here. So we've got this 1 block gap here, got 1, then you got a 2 block gap, then 2. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Just like that. Do the same on the other side, and then we can get back onto this crazy bit now. Okay, another small kind of detail that I might miss a little bit later on is the kind of steps that actually come back on the side. So you can either bring these down to the red layer, or if you want, you can bring them down all the way to the water, like this. Well, this actually. So this is for the kind of small boats that it has, so you can actually get onto it this way. So I'll just show you how to do this. So when it comes to the back of the ship itself, it's just on this section here. Leave this one here. And all you're going to do is just bring your stairs down like so. If you want it to go right to the water and you've built it the same as me, or if you're kind of going to MC edit in like I do, then bring it down to one layer of green. If not, bring it down to the layer of whatever water you've got. And I've just put upside down stairs on these parts like this. Then you're going to have it going up by one again. And then on the back part of this, I put down a slab. And then continue this up, cut out into the deck here. So it's directly in the middle of this gun, it should be lining up. You got this bit here, and I tried to put in an upside down stair like this. And if you want to, you can put in an upside down stair here instead, or here. Then it wraps around. So it's up to you kind of what you want to do on this part. So yeah, that's how you kind of do the step. I'll do the same on the other side as well and try and explain it a bit better. So find this part at the back here. Here, just go down your stairs. I'm going to go all the way down so that it would be touching the water. Put your upside down stairs in just to make it look a bit smoother. And then what you can do is you have another stair here, and then a slab or an upside down stair. I'll put an upside down stair already. And to make it easy, I'm going to put my upside down stair in here like that. There you go, your stair. Cut out part of the deck, so you are actually cutting into the deck for this part, and it should be directly in the middle of that gun. So that kind of sorts out those side parts. So now we're going to really start setting up lots of this kind of quite complicated part. Okay, and then look at your middle section, and you should have four guns on this kind of longer run. So you got one, two, three, four. Find the middle of this. So cut out the middle three, so you should have three blocks on each side, or three fences on each side even. Two fences on each side. So you got these two fences like this on each side between the guns. And this is just going to be a 3x3 kind of box, basically. Leave the back open, and it's just going to go up, and be built up to three high in total. And the roof is going to be filled in like this. I'll just cut out one of these holes here, and you can put in a stone slab either on the bottom part or on the top. It's up to you. I usually put it on the bottom so that you can still see out as a player, whereas this kind of stops your actual height, stops you from seeing through. Then all you're going to do is just place an iron block right in the middle. I put two stone slabs on each side of these, and to finish it off, place down some weighted pressure plates just on the top of this part here. What you can also do on this part, actually, which I don't think I did on mine, is put two buttons down. Just like that. We'll do the same on the other side, so come over to the other side. So I've got the different type of guns on this side, so it might be a bit confusing. So then find your four, so you've got one, two, three, four. Go right to the middle of these. Between these, make a three, so you have two fences on each side. 3x3 box in total, so you've got one, two, three, one, two, three. Leave an opening at the back. Let's build this up. Three high in total. Cover up the roof. Cut in a hole here, put in your slab. Put a block on the top, right in the middle. Two slabs kind of coming outside. Put your weighted pressure plate on there, and you can put your buttons in as well. So this is also a really good place to hide in a torch as well. So I put in my torches on this, just in this part here, so that it mainly lights behind the actual deck itself. But because of that slab, it doesn't come out too much. So you can see here, so it kind of lights around the back. I still haven't sorted out the lighting on this build anyway. So let's get on to the next part. Okay, so we're going to build this kind of this part of the bridge. I think the actual bridge, or the viewing section or something like that, is this part here. I think this is actually the armoured bridge part here. So come to the front. You're going to leave a two block gap between these parts here, and you're just going to have a three like this. And you have one on each side, then two, and then you're going to have five across the back. One, two, three, four, five. So you've just got that kind of shape there. And just build this up to a total height of 6, so you got counting this block, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Do that on these parts, and I'll show you what to do next. Okay, and now we're going to build some kind of viewports for these parts. So you've just got two slabs on the kind of front part, and then on this set of two is just the first one here. So they're really, really small kind of viewing ports. I'll show you what I mean in a second when I actually build it up. And then on the side parts here, you're just going to add an extra five blocks. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Same again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Build this up by 5. Again, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 3, 4, and 5. And then on top of these as well, build up by 5. So like that. So that's how what I mean by the viewports there. They're really, really small ones. Like this. So you've got really small viewports. You can't see anything at the front. So do that, and then we'll cut out the extra ones. So just build that up by an extra 5. Okay, once you've built that up, what you're going to do is you're just going to leave one block here, and then you're going to do exactly the same kind of pattern as you did lower down, just like this. Then you're going to fill this deck in with grey wool. Well, it's not really a deck, this part is just the top section. You're going to fill in with grey wool, like this. Find the middle, place down a block of iron, and you're just going to come out twice with your stone slabs, just like that. Place weighted pressure plates around the outside of this entire section. Again, this is kind of an optional bit. I think it makes it look a little bit better. So just build that up, and then same again, you can put your buttons on these parts, same as we did on those side parts. So this kind of creates the armoured command bridge section, so you can actually go in here, you can have a kind of a look around, just like that. So now we'll get onto the actual kind of, I guess it's an observation tower, observation deck, part of that, so we'll just build that up now. Okay, so we're just going to build a couple of these three secondary guns, which are on each side as well. We might as well place them down now. As always, I might just forget them, so as I'm working this way until we get to the back guns, I might as well start doing all of the side bits as well. I'll make it a little bit easier and make sure I don't forget. So we've got the higher gun right at the front. What you're going to do is you're going to leave two blocks here. It's going to be the third one here, and you're going to put your stone. These guns are made exactly the same as these ones here. So you've got your stair on the front, an upside down stair there. And then you've got two stone slabs coming out. And there's three of these in total. They're going back diagonally. So what you're going to do is you're just going to, if you're going to put in a diagonal here, you're going to go again diagonally. So you can put in this one as a placeholder, and you get these two. Put in exactly the same, stone brick stairs. Upside down ones on the back of them, come forwards by two of your stone slabs. You can actually place the box like that. This also gives you enough room to walk in between them and around them and all those kind of things. If you're on vaults, you could probably use something like the gun turrets or even possibly the rail guns on these if you're building this in that. So I'll show you where to do them on the other side as well, because it's a really easy part. So you've got a two block gap, place down this one. All you're going to do is just go diagonally by 5 in total and then cut out a couple of them. That might be an easier way of thinking about it. Oh, and then put your stone bricks there on the top of each of these, upside down right on the back. Get your stone slab out, come forwards by 2 on each of these, just like that. And that finishes off the secondary guns, which are on the side parts of these. Okay, now building for the actual observation part itself, what you're going to do is off the back of this part, you're going to come across by 3. Coming towards the side of the ship. This is actually going to be 3 long itself. It comes back by 3 as well. This place, this part actually is just basically a doorway. So we can build that. So you can actually put in the doorway. So you've got this 3 here. There's a 3 coming across, but this part's a door. So you can put in your door here, which comes in through here. And then behind this, what you can do is come in here and go 3, just like this. And then a 2. And there'll be a 3 across the back, so you just join around there. This will be 3 high in total, so build this up by 2, just like this. Go all the way around, just build this small section up. Okay, so once you've built that up, what you can do is just come over the doors and place a block. So I'm just going to put in wooden doors because usually I use iron on all of my kind of warships, but it just makes it a little bit easier to actually get inside if we ever needed to show it. So we've got those coming over the top there. And then on the front part of this, what you're going to do is just going to put down 2 sets of slabs on the top part. And it's the same on the other side as well. So you've got this part here, and then comes across like this, just like that. Then coming on the back of this part, counting this block here because it goes all the way straight back. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So it overhangs by 1 on this section here. So count in that block there, 1. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Come across the back. This one's also going to be 3 high, so just build this part up. And then what you can do is you can fill in this kind of deck section here with grey wool, just like this. Going all the way across, like that. And then come around to the back part of this section, leave three blocks, and on the fourth one you're going to cut out for a door. You can switch this one out for a grey block. It can get seen a little bit on here, as you can see right here. But it's up to you what you want to do, if you want to do it like that or not. So that's where your door goes. So you can pop that one in. Same on the other side as well. So you've got 1, 2, 3, it's the fourth block. Change this one up for grey, put in your door, just like that. Okay, then come to this kind of part here. And we're just going to place down a slab on each of these sides, like this. Then what you're going to have is just going to have a couple of stairs going down to the same level, this level here. Same on the other side. So got a couple of stairs, like this. We'll go down to the same level as where you got your door. So if there was deck in here, but we're not going to put in deck, we're going to actually use slabs for the floor. And then underneath this step, what you're going to do is put in two slabs, and it's going to be four long in total, like this. So you've got four long. And then just wrap this around the outside, and it comes just over the door. It's a bit of a weird part, this. So again, two. Let's go. Got 1, 2, 3, and four like this, and then this is just going to wrap around the kind of doorway. On the outside of this part, what you're going to do is have some iron bars. So you can make these iron bars go one past, to actually just double check to make sure it was there. So you have them going one past, and then all you're going to do is you're going to make some stairs that go up to this part itself. So just like this. So there's your stairs that kind of go up here. So then you've got a way up kind of railing. You can get around here onto this back part that then keeps on going up. There's quite a lot of stairs on this build. So do the same on the other side here. So you're just going to build up your stairs really easily. And then just to finish off these stair parts, what you're going to do is put you're going to put stairs under kind of a upside down, and probably actually not that one. So you've got these ones going up here upside down, and then goes onto your stone slabs. And the same on these parts here as well. I just put in upside down stairs and kept that slab just like this. Okay, and then come to still keep on building up onto this platform. So above your door, add three blocks of whatever material you're using for the main hull of the deck. Then join these two together and add one to each side like this. Then with your iron bars, just come around the outside. You're going to create a railing. This will also be all the way up to where you've got the steps, so make sure that you don't go over this one, otherwise people won't be able to get in. Let's bring this around like this. And then come to the middle of this part, and just on each of these sides, just going to add an extra two blocks on these. Then on these outside parts, you're going to go out diagonally for an extra two. So it's at the same height as these two here. This is just kind of like the support part for the actual deck itself, like this. And then what you're going to do is grab your grey wool. I'm just going to place down three blocks of wool in here. And you're going to have your stone stairs just coming up here. So when you go around this section, you've got stone stairs going up here. It's also going to be, this bit's a bit more difficult to do. There's going to be three stone stairs coming up onto the top section as well. So you can put those in now. So then you've got this kind of walk around. It's not the most safe walk around ever. But this will take you up onto this higher deck when we do get to build it. And then the same again, what I've been doing with the other stairs, just put your upside down ones in. I think it makes it look a bit better, because this looks a bit too, I'm not too sure, it just doesn't look very stable or anything like that. So just put them on the back side of those, and that'll sort that part out. Okay, then what you're going to do is, off this, you're going to come across the side, this time of a stone slab, so you've got a full block of stone slab. Add one on each side. And this is just going to be on the upper side of it. The actual deck is pretty thin itself. Bring this all the way across. And again, this part here will be going up to a full block. Bring it around. Just like this. And then fill this part in here. This just creates part of the actual section. This is going to be the two side bits that stick out. So this is what we're actually creating right now. This part here, so we'll get into the next bit. And then come around to the back, you're going to add five blocks, well, not five blocks, five slabs, just like this, right in the middle, just like that, to the extra bit. Also on these parts, you can actually connect these in. I forgot about that almost then. So just put an extra slab on those two, so it makes it look like it's actually joined in. And then again, you're going to come forwards by five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5. So it should just overhang just over this kind of armored bridge, I guess we could call it. Yeah, we'll call it the armored bridge. And it's 5 foot across as well. Let's bring this around, then leave a space for you to actually walk up onto the top of this part and walk down here. So that's exactly the... Nope, we just get rid of that block there. So there we go. So that's what you need for that part. And now we're just going to build up this part around here. And then what you're going to do is you're just going to go around three, and there's five across the front, and there's three on the side. So you've just got this really simple kind of design for this section. Just put glass right on top of that. Then put stone slabs on the top of this part, and just double these parts up like this. And what we're going to do now is we're going to just put bars around the side, and then we'll build up the next section up. So it does go up really, really high. So the next part you need to do is just put iron bars around the kind of outside of this section, and it should just join around. Around all these outside parts, like this, which joins into the back part of this. So then you've got this kind of side part that actually looks out, which is quite cool. So you can actually look over the ship. Well, there's nothing at the back at the minute, but you can look over at the front at the minute. So let's go on to the next part. And then counting these three blocks, what you're going to do is you're going to go back by eight. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So these are in the slabs. Just the front part has the actual full blocks on them. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And this comes across the back like this. And then just fill in your roof for this part. And then what you're going to do is find the back and just add two blocks. Two blocks. So you got three in total, and then you got a one extra. So it just kind of curves in a little bit. So you got three sets of two. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, and then you got a one, just like that. On the back as well, what you got is you got a six blocks, 3 by 2 blocks. Sorry guys, I'm starting to sign away. Probably might need a break on this tutorial now. But yeah, you got this kind of block part here. I'll just finish off this section, then I'm definitely having a break. And then what you're going to do is you're going to leave a 2 block gap from the back part. So you're going to be in the middle of this part and go up by 7 iron blocks or light grey wool blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And then around the outside, as we've been doing with the kind of lower section, just put your iron bars like, well, not like so, I was going to say like this, but like this. Right, done. Okay. So you've got that section now. And then at the front, I've got this kind of, I've actually added an extra 3 slabs, which I almost forgot about. Sorry about that, guys. Right, so then wrap your stairs around these parts like that. And I've just put in a cobblestone wall and a block of yellow wool. It's probably the like most colour that's on this ship, to be honest. There is this kind of weird bit at the top. I'm not too sure what it is. But you do get quite a nice view from the actual top of this section. So now we're just going to build up the antenna, and we are done with the observation bridge part. Okay, before I forget, we actually need to get a kind of have a way of getting up here. So coming forwards off this antenna, I just knocked out this block here, and this is where I put in my stairs. That was a really weird way of doing it. So we got the stairs here, and they basically come in over the last set, so you can walk up here if you take out this block. There you go, so you can come now walk up here. I'm just going to double check to make sure this is in the right place so I can walk down as well. Yeah, so you can walk down on this one. Of course, if you put these in, you can't walk down. So you can always move it back, but then you're actually knocking out of this part. So it's kind of difficult to get the stairs in here. What you might want to also do, possibly, is actually bring this antenna down all the way to here, and then you can have a ladder going up. That's another idea. It really depends on what you kind of want. I don't think it looks too bad. It doesn't look terrible. Then again, now that I've got all these here, and I actually forgot about this part. There we go. So now that you've got those, it does look a little bit bad now. But it's up to you what you want to do with this part. Now let's finish off the antenna. And then off this iron bar, what you're going to do is add 5 slabs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Same on the other side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And you're just going to add an extra 3 on the back and an extra 3 again, just like this. So you're kind of creating this back section. Now what you're going to do is have your never rick fence. This just goes pretty much on top of this, but it goes out by 1 on each of these stone slab parts. And it goes around the back as well. just like this, and comes out by one, just like that. And then what you're going to do is, with Black War, you're going to go up by 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And you're going to come out by 4 with the fence. 1, 2, 3, 4. And again on the other side, 1, 2, 3, 4. The antenna for this is pretty simple, so we just need to get to the last bit. And then what you're going to do is grab cobblestone wool. If you haven't got cobblestone wool, pick another type of fence or something like that. Go up by 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And you're going to go up by 2 in total with the fence, and then add one on the back, and just go up to the sides with 2. So it's a pretty easy kind of design for that antenna, but that finishes off another section. So you're doing really, really well, guys. I'm going to take a break because I'm going nuts. You guys should probably, if you haven't stopped already. See you guys in a bit. Alright, so I've had a break and I'm feeling a little bit less nuts. So what we're going to do now is actually build up these smoke stacks. And then we'll start building these kind of small boats. These small boats that I've actually made, or this one's actually a pretty big boat. It's just kind of a couple of random ideas. So you can kind of mix and match these. They're just pretty simple designs. You can put them... I haven't put a boat on here, so you can put an extra boat on there or something like that. I think the other side is completely... Yeah, the other side's completely empty. I've got this kind of big one here, which has got a gun on it. It's kind of up to you what you want to do with the little boats. I'll give you the ideas. I'll tell you how to do these ones when we get to that. But let's get onto the smokestacks themselves and set them up. And then we've got this middle section. And after we've done this, we've just got this big antenna part here. And we're pretty much done with the build. So we're pretty close to finishing, guys. Okay, so setting up for the smokestacks themselves, what you're going to do is you're going to come behind your observation deck. And you're going to leave a 2-block gap. And just come across by 3. And what you're going to do is you're going to have 2 coming across this way, so we'll do the same on the other side as well. Then connecting onto this one and counting this one as well, it's going to be 9, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7, 8 and 9, I'm just going to recount those. One, same on the other side, so counting this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Then you have a 4, 1, 2, 3 and 4, so this just comes in, 1, 2, 3, 4, then you have a 3 across the back. Just like that. So that builds up the kind of base of these actual smokestacks themselves. You're just going to build this up to a total height of 3. So do that and I'll get back to you. And then once you've done that, the smokestacks themselves are really easy. You're just going to add 3 blocks here, just building up this part. And you can have a 4 going across the back. 1, 2, 3, 4. And you have a 3. 1, 1, 2, and 3. Just like that. So that's the kind of basis for that one. The back one is exactly the same. You're going to have 1, 2, 3, and a 4. So this one just builds on top of the last one. Then 3. And a 4. So you get those two for the actual basis of the smokestacks, and then counting the block that you've just placed, it's going to go up by 13 in total. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. And then just build all of those bits up in your light grey wool or iron blocks up to 13, and I'll get back to you. And then once you've built up both of those up to a total height of 13 with those blocks, what you're going to do is add 2 layers of black on top of the light grey wool or iron blocks themselves. So it's pretty easy. I'm just going to show you how to do one. The other one is exactly the same. So you build those up by 2, and then on the inside all you do is you just come in one layer. Hopefully you guys can see this. So you're just coming around the outside, so you've got this 2 kind of hole, and this is one level below, so that would be up a level, if that makes sense. Hopefully that makes sense. So yeah, again, what you can do is said with the Type 42 destroyer, you can put in your cobwebs and you can go all the way up and kind of make some sort of smoke trail. It's kind of up to you what you want to do with those. As it takes quite a while with the cobwebs to actually get it to look really nice. If you do have it up, see, it looks awesome when you start doing this. So do it on the same one and we'll get onto this kind of bottom part. It's a bit in the middle here. Okay, so once you've done both of those, what you're going to do is come in on this side and on the inside kind of too, because it's uneven, it's actually on the odd, I'll just put it on the inside, just have some ladders going up the sides, and the same on this one as well, it's on the inside of this 4, bring it all the way up, just like this, and do it on all 4 sides, and I'll get on to the next part. Okay, for the next bit, come into the middle of this part, and all you're going to do is just put it in light grey wool, just like this. It's pretty easy, this part. Not light grey wool, sorry, grey wool. Yep, you put in your grey wool like that, and we're just going to build up these middle parts now. Okay, so for the first kind of platform, what you're going to do is you're going to come in right into the centre and go in by 1. And just go up by two with your iron blocks or light grey wool. And do a double slab on the top of these. Connect them together as well, like this. And then bring them around the side as well, so you make it three wide in total. And then just to finish it off, all you're going to do is put some iron bars on each side like this. So it's a really, really simple thing. There is supposed to be some sort of stairs that join into it, but because we're in Minecraft, it gets really cramped. The stairs themselves are really steep, so they actually go up a bit crazily. What you could do, again, is put in, you know, some sort of ladder up here. But it's really up to you. Then what you're going to do is you're going to count up three blocks like this, and then on the upper side, you're just going to build across like that. Same on the other side, so you're going to count up three blocks, one, two, three, and come across like this, and then come forwards just like this. You don't join these two together. That's the only difference. It's supposed to be two separate platforms. And then on this part here, we can just put down a cobblestone wall or a fence of some sort, and then put a black piece of wall on top. And then all I did is I put around loads of loads of iron bars around the sides, and that just finishes off. Yeah, that does. That just finishes off the smokestacks themselves. So I'm actually going to go on to the next section, because the boats lay on top of a lot of things. I'm going to go on to the next section, which is behind this here. So let's do it. Okay, so the next section, what you're going to do is you're going to come to the back of the smokestack. This is the back of the ship at the minute. And you're just going to come across and make a seven long. You're going to leave a one block gap, so it's a pretty thin kind of gap here. Just make this seven long. One, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. Then counting this one, you're going to go back by four. One, two, three, four. Same other side. One, two, three, four. Like that. And come in. Four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Join these up, and it should be five across the back. So that's what you should have for this part. And then what you're going to do is you're going to build this up to a height of three. So build this up all the way, and I'll get back to you. Okay, then fill this whole part in with your grey wool. Just like this. Like that. And then if that's the front of the ship, on this part here, count in three blocks, and on the third block, place a block, go up by three, put on a stone slab, and then you're just going to put buttons around this one. So this is just kind of some part of it, and it's not in the centre because there's actually a boat that lays on top of here, and I put in the bigger boat so I had to move things about, but it actually looks better, a little bit more random. And then we're going to build a kind of small funnel type thing. It's not the best design, but find the back of this part, and go up by two right in the middle. On the sides of these, go up by two each, then just have a one block on the front. And you're going to have stone slabs on each of these parts, and it's going to be a block of iron. So that's kind of what I came up with for this thing. Actually, there is a stone slab on here. It's kind of like a really small funnel. You can either have it like that or like that. And you can put a torch in here as well, so it's kind of an extra place for you to put lighting and hide it. It's kind of up to you if you want to put in this part or not. And there's just one little bit extra to build on here. And then behind this part here, leave a block gap. And this one's going to be in the middle. It's going to go up by four. One, two, three, and four. Put a stone slab on it. And then you're going to have two stone slabs coming out on each side. Just like this. And I just put some ladder up on this part. I have no idea what it is. but it looks quite cool when everything kind of is around it. It kind of just juts out a little bit. So let's get on to the next part. Okay, so for the next part, what you're going to do is you're going to leave a one block gap. And it's going to be a five. Just add a block on the end of each of these, like this. So it makes it kind of two here. You're going to go out. You have two showing. Same on the other side. So go out. Have two showing. Just have one in, so you're making this kind of L shape, like this. And you're going to go out and do a three. One, two, and three, like this. And across the back, it should be nine. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and nine. So it should be the three that connects across there. Just like that, so that's that part. Then build this up to a total height of two, do that. Okay, once you build that up to a height of two, what you're going to do is these side parts here, you're going to build up to a total height of four and then put a stone slab on. Might as well put this in now. So that's just a bit that's sticking out here. And then what you're going to do on this is the back of the ship, just in case you're getting turned around a lot. On these three here, you're going to come over by two with the slabs, then three slabs, and this is just going to go straight across the back. On the other side, you've got two slabs and three slabs, like that. And then behind this, put in your iron blocks. It's going to be built up by to a total height of two, just behind this, like that. Then put on your weighted pressure plates. Behind this as well, there's going to be another one. This actually goes to a height of three. So it's kind of going around it, like that. And we'll get to the next part. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're just going to add an extra three blocks onto each of the parts that are kind of left. Okay, so once you've built that up to the same height as this one, what you can do is just fill this in with grey wool, like this. Nice and simple. And then on this front part here, so back of the ship's there, we're going to just come across by five. Build this up to a total height of 3, that's why I'm getting confused. And same on the back, like this. There's a couple of details we need to just put into this part now. Okay, so on this 3, you're going to build an extra 2 blocks like this. And you're going to put in a cobblestone slab kind of roof. I just use cobblestone, so it's a bit different from the other parts. And then on the front, get your stone slab out. You're just going to cut out 2 parts on this. I'm just going to put in these kind of strange things here. I think there's supposed to be some sort of viewing area here. But because we're in Minecraft and the walls are so thick, I just couldn't fit it in. And on the back, there's just going to be one just like that. And then just to finish off this little bit here, we're going to put 2 stone slabs coming out the side of this block. And then you're going to have a button on the faces that are left, so the front and on the back. And then just to finish off this part, you can just put in some weighted pressure plates. Like that, and around. And just leave the middle, kind of 5 at the back, because we're just going to build the antenna now. Okay, so the antenna gets built on the back of here. Just going to go up by 6 blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And come up by 3, 1, 2, 3. Same on the other side. 1, 2, and 3. And they're going to just come across the back by 5 in total, like this. And then across the front by 5. And then in the middle of these kind of, well, not in the middle of these sections, one block, one slab from the end, you're just going to place down another block. It's going to have a pressure plate on it, weighted pressure plate, or normal pressure plate, it's up to you what you want to use, and then just put your buttons around the side. So that finished off that part, so now we need to build up the longer part of the mast. And then from this centre part, you're going to add another 11 blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11, just like this. And then again with your stone slabs, you're going to come across by 5 this time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is exactly the same as this part here, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Add 3 on the back, and add an extra 3 on the back. And then with your nether brick fence, you're just going to come across and come over by 1. And this just wraps around the back as well, leaving this gap here. Just come around here and go up by 1. And now we've just got a little bit left. Then what you're going to do is add 10 blocks of black wool. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then add 4 nether brick fences to each side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. There we go. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Just on those 2 sides like that. And then we have cobblestone wall, but if you don't have cobblestone wall, use a fence. Just got by 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then add 2 fences to the top. And on the kind of one part, go out by 1 on the back. And then just add 2 onto each side. Like this. So that finishes off the main kind of superstructure part of it. We've got loads and loads of little bits of detail to do. We've got a couple more secondary guns, and we've mainly got the cranes to do as well. They're on the side, and of course the boats, which kind of connect into the kind of back part, this back part here, and also into the stacks themselves. So let's get to it. Okay, so now we're going to build the cranes themselves. So the cranes are actually facing backwards, if that makes sense. So the actual crane part is going backwards. So what we're going to do is, from the back, you're going to find your kind of backmost smokestack, find where the ladder is. Coming one block to the side, you're going to count 3 blocks, like there, and then on the 4th one, you're going to place down an iron block. Then from this, you're just going to create a cross pattern. This will be built up to a total height of 3. You can fill in the middle if you want to. I usually do, because I get bats spawning in pretty much everywhere. And then the front of the ship is this way, so what you're going to do is you actually put on your ladders to get up on this side. There's going to be 3 slabs as well on the other sides. And then this is going to go up straight. We'll just build... I'll just tell you where to put... the other one on the other side as well, but I'll only show you how to do one side, then you can just flip it over, but at least now you have the kind of place where it is. So the back of the ship is here, you've got your smokestack, got your ladder, count 3 blocks from this inside part here, place a block, make a cross pattern, go up by 3 in total, and you can fill in the middle as well, and this is the front of the ship, so find where the front of the ship is, and that side is where your ladders are going to be, then on the other ones you're going to have your stone slabs. Okay, and then in the middle of this one, you're going to add 11 blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. And place a stone slab on. You can do it on the other side as well, now that you've got that base. I'll just show you how to do it on one of them. Then what you're going to do is you're going to find the top of this, and you're going to go down one block, and place a slab. This is going towards the back of the ship, and you're going to have 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then you're going to have to come on the back side, not the back side, the underneath. It's going to go down by one slab. This is going to be 3 like this. So that part's pretty easy. Now we're going to build up where the actual controller sits. So what you're going to do is, from this back part here, you're going to count 1, 2, 3, and 4. And just on the side, add a slab. Add one to the front. Well, by the front, I mean the front facing the back. So if this is actually the back of it, because you're going up it, so that'll be the front, if that makes sense. But it's going to be 4 long in total, so you're going to have 2 overhanging on the ladder side. That might be easier. You got another 4, and then in the middle of these you got a 2 like this. You can put nether brick fences around the sides of these like this. You're going to have a ladder going up the back up to this point, so you can actually go up here onto the block and then come up here, and then you'll be up onto this control part. I just put a piece of grey wool for the actual control panel, put a lever on the top of it, and put a button just on the back like this, so then do it the same on the other side. Now what I'm going to do is going to do the connecting part that goes into the crane as well. So from this platform, count up one block. So you're going to leave a one block gap, so it's going to be on the second. This will come up by 3. Then it's going to go diagonal, and you're going to go up by 3 again, and then another 3. So these two with the slabs as well, it shouldn't be touching at all. And what you do is you put your nether brick fence on the back, or normal fence. That should just connect into this part here. And then all you really need to do to finish it off is actually just add a couple going down here, and then I made a kind of claw shape. I'm not going to make these. I'll show you exactly what I did with these ones, because if I fly over, because I've got two of the bigger kind of boats on the sides, I've actually got them at different levels. So what I'll do is on these I'm going to leave mine blank, but it's up to you if you want to do the exact same boat design. I'll show you how to do those for the side parts. If not, come up with your own one. It might be quite interesting for, you know, for you guys to build your own one. So you can leave those blank, and that finishes off the crane. So do it the same on the other side, and we'll start setting up these side boat parts and secondary guns. Okay, now we're going to build the actual platforms for the small boats. These are actually the small boats on the side. There's actually 4 kind of platforms for them in total, so you could put 4 small boats in this part, but it'll be quite a bit of a squeeze. So find your forwardmost smokestack, which is just before the observation deck. On this block here, you're just going to come onto this kind of upper part here, just add 2 slabs, then you're going to have a stone brick stair, and 2 slabs, a stone brick stair. The reason I've got the stone brick stairs is because, I'll show you now actually, this is just so you got a slight raised bit for the actual boats to go on. This one's not 100%, you could actually, if you wanted to, put in this like that, but I haven't done on this one because you can't really see it. So I've just put those in kind of for the bits that actually connect into the boats themselves. What you're then going to do is, on the back of these, you're going to add 5 slabs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then, again, you're going to have your stone brick stair, or any other type of stair. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And a stair. And then connect these two here, and then connect it into the actual deck itself. And then for the supports on these, what you're going to do is, underneath these stairs, you're just going to put down a couple of fences. It's a bit of a difficult thing to get into here. There we go. So you just put in your fences, so then we'll do the same on the other side as well. I might as well show you it, as it's very, very easy. So find your forwardmost smokestack, and on the top part here, add 2 stone slabs. Then you have a stone brick stair, and 2 slabs, and stone brick stair. Then add 5 slabs, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And you're going to add your stone brick stair on each of these, and just connect these two together, and then connect it into the actual stack itself. Underneath your stone brick stair, what you can do is put in your fence, just like this. So it's really easy for these kind of bits, and you can still walk around underneath it and things like that, which is always useful. So those are the kind of side small parts. We're actually going to build up the back parts as well before doing the boats, because the boats do lay on top and it gets really kind of cramped in there. Okay, I just double checked. There is one extra kind of support on these. In between the middle of these parts here, what you can do is add an extra couple of fences right in the middle. So that's all I missed, so do the same on the other side as well. Okay, so for the back kind of ones that are built off this part here, they are just a little bit different. So what you're going to do is find your kind of, this is the back of the ship, so you got it behind this mast. Find this block here, you're going to come in by 1, go 2. And then what I did, instead of having them going this way like that, what I did is I had them going this way. The reason is that then with the big boats, because you've only got one boat on them, I'll actually show you, it's going to be a lot easier to explain. So I've got them kind of going like this, so this looks like it's supporting the bigger boats just a little bit better. So it's up to you if you want to do it the same way as those, or if you want to do it this way here. So once you've got those two slabs and you've got that part there, what you're going to do is add another two slabs. And then this part gets a bit tricky, so you've got to put your stone stair like that, so you've got this kind of bit in the middle. It is on the even, you can make it odd if you want to, it's up to you. I just had mine kind of laying across the top of it, and it might have been overhanging on one of the sides or something like that. And then we're going to do the same as you did before, the five slabs, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then you're going to have your stone brick stair, and your stone brick stair, like this, and join them together. And then this one, of course, we're only connecting to by one, because this shape is a little bit different. Exactly the same as we did before with your nether brick fence or normal fence. Put them on where you've got the actual stone brick stairs themselves. And then the same as the other one as well, it's going to be in the middle parts. And both of these platforms are exactly the same on each side. So there we go, that's that. So build the same thing on the other side. Okay, so we're just going to put in the secondary guns because I'll probably forget them otherwise. Just a couple more to put in. So if you come to the back of the ship and you've got your ladder here, what you're going to do is... So this is your ladder here, what you're going to do is you're going to come in one block. If that makes sense, one block diagonal, you're going to leave a one block walk here. You've got a stone brick stair, upside down stair, and then come forwards. Oh, without destroying half of the deck. Come forwards with two stone slabs. I'll do the same on the other side as well, it's very easy. So you've got this ladder here, come in one block, place down your stone brick, put your stone brick stairs upside down on the back, and then two slabs, and now we've only got another four of these to do. Okay, so near the back of the ship, it's just going to move a little bit forwards. Where you've got this gun here, this first one that's near the back of the ship here, what you're going to do is you're going to come in directly in line with it, and you're going to place down a block. So you've got a one block on this side, and you've got a couple on this side before you get to the boats. Then put your stone brick stair, upside down one, then two slabs, same on the other side. So find, there we go, this one here. Come in by one, put your stone brick stairs, upside down, and two slabs, just like that. So in total, you're going to have three guns, three small guns pointing that way, and you've got these really cool three diagonal guns going the other way. Never mind, don't listen to me, there's only four in total pointing to the back. You've actually got a total of eight pointing towards the front on this one. So then find your next kind of gun. You've got this blob here, whatever it is, and then you've got your gun here, you've got two guns on this stretch. It's on this one here. What you're going to do is you're going to come forwards towards the front of the ship. This is the front of the ship here. So you just got it off this diagonal here. There should be a block to walk around on each of the sides. Then you've got your stone brick, stair, upside down stair, and not lower brick, two stone slabs. Same on the other side. So you've got your gun, the two guns. It's this one here. Come in, so this would be in line if it was, but you're actually going to come forwards by one, stone brick stair, upside down stair, then two stone slabs. So that's all of the secondary guns. You've got all the side guns, you've got all the kind of small deck guns, you've got the massive guns. So now we just got a couple of boats and we are done with this build. Well done. Okay, so we're now onto the small boats, which is just the last detail. What I'm going to do is I'll show you exactly what I've done for my small boats. They're pretty simple. There's some really big ones. There's this kind of weird one here, which you've got a inside deck. We've got some seats here, and you've got a kind of gun on the front. It's a bit of a weird one, but I'll show you how to build just a couple of these ideas. The best thing to do, really, is just come up with your own, base them off, maybe even base them off mine, or base them off ideas that you've got. Put them in and just see what you can kind of come up with, because there's quite a lot of space on this ship itself for loads and loads of boats. You know, you've got... You could have four small boats in total on the front part, and if you wanted to, you could have two big boats, which I've got two big boats and I've got two small, just kind of dotted around. This one's really terrible. I actually hate it, which is why it's kind of hidden. So let's get on to the first one anyway. Okay, so for the first one, there's kind of like four boats on the front. I only put one on this side, one on the entire kind of side of this, so I put it right next to the actual smokestack itself. You're actually going to need some sort of block to build off. So when you've got this one on the inside, I used a different type of kind of planks, which I need to get this one upside down. So I used oak wood planks for these. I usually use oak wood planks for my kind of small boats. Just go forwards by one, then what you're going to do is you're going to come sideways. It's going to be 7 in total. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 6, and 7. Actually, we're going to make it 8. We might as well. I'll just show you a kind of rough idea. Then wrap these around the back. And it's just going to go to the front. This is where it starts getting complicated because it's all kind of close in together, but you should have enough room to get it done. There we go. Let's bring these around. So that's the kind of basis that I used. And then what I did is, with the slabs, on these parts. So you're just going to come across the bottom, the floor on these with the slabs. And that was the kind of basic design. Then all I did is I just put cobblestone slabs on most of the back part. And I believe I left the back open. I usually do with these kind of boats. What you can also do, if you want to put in kind of like seats, what you can do is put in extra slabs, which gives you this kind of ribbing part as if someone's sitting down. So that's the kind of first small idea anyway. We'll do the other two small ones, which you can just mix and match, throw them wherever you really want to on these sections. So let's get onto it. Okay, the next small boat, I did this on the other side, and it's onto this back section where we've got the bigger boats. And just off this one, I just put in three stairs going across here. It's not connected to this part because I've got the bigger boat on there. It's going to go forwards by five, counting this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, and 5. And then at the front, I usually have just this part here, and then wrap around more stairs. This is where it gets really in close and it gets really difficult. Just like that. And all I did was just put in a really simple floor like this. It's the worst kind of small boat that I've got on this build. It's actually quite difficult to get in kind of the right sections as well for this. So you maybe, you wouldn't want to raise that up. It's kind of difficult. I'm sure you guys can come up with something a little bit better. Maybe you can just put in one of the kind of seat parts there. And if you did want to, you can put on your cobblestone wall, cobblestone slab around it like that. It makes it look a little bit better. I actually left mine like it is because I didn't really care too much about it. And also because the big ship, well, not the big ship, the bigger boat that I had next to it is actually got a lot of cobblestone on it as if it's like armor. So I left it like that. So let's do another small boat. Okay, so for the other small boat, I put it right next to this part here, and it actually comes in here. So you have to build up a block here to put in the first one, and put it on the back here, so you've got an upside down stair. This will be three wide again, like this. And that goes forwards by seven, counting this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And then this is where it gets really difficult. This is your forwardmost one, like this. And you've got them going across the side again, just joining into the back part. And it's very, very difficult at this part, so you have to kind of cram yourself into a small place and try and get it to work. I'm pretty sure it's that. No, it's kind of gone around there. It might be worth building up a block here and then putting in like that. And then the floor again is really simple, like this. And then this one I did put the cobblestone kind of slabs on top of it. So this one's really crammed in right into here and right into here. And then again, you can put in a couple of the kind of seat parts. And now we're going to build up the big boat here, and then we've just got one other bigger boat. Okay, so we're going to build up the first big boat, which comes on the side here. So what you're going to do is just build directly on top of this one and go again. And what you're going to do is this actually overhangs on the back by two blocks. So you've got an overhang of two here. Across the back, it's going to go five. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And you've got 11 counting this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. If I can get them the right way around, like that. Then, because it's 5 wide, what you're going to have is you're going to have two of these parts going forwards, like that. It should be right next to this. Do the same on this side, so you get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. You've got one coming forwards like this. And then you'll notice that you've got these gaps in here. All you're going to do is just fill in the floor with your wooden planks, not wooden planks, your wooden slabs. And what you can do also with all these ships is obviously mix and match the slabs, so that makes it a bit different. I just made all of mine out of oak. But it's up to you what you want to do. Put your cobblestone kind of slabs on all of these parts like this. And then across the front, what I did is I built up this part here, and then went across by three. And I actually went across on these slabs here instead. You can build them if you want to on the floor part here. It's up to you what you want to have, what you think looks better. So you can either have this style of doing them, or unfortunately when you rip them out, obviously it does turn it into a full block, or you can have them going across to beam like this. On my one, if you want exactly the same as what I did, I just put them across like this. So you got that kind of tiny gap in it, it gives it a bit more depth. So that completes the first kind of big boat, which you've got all these kind of seated parts. So now I've just got one more big boat and we're done. Okay, for the last big boat, what you can do is off this back part, build it up by one block here. This is just a place down this part here. This part's only going to overhang by one. This run is going to be 10 in total. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And then across the back, instead of going straight across like we've been doing like this, what you're going to do is you're actually going to come out like this and go across by three. So it gives it a bit more shape. It will be touching with this one because there's grey. There's actually the cobblestone wall. It doesn't. Cobblestone wall, cobblestone slabs, it doesn't look too bad. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And the front is the same as the big boat, so you've got these two kind of side bits, and then you've got this last one like this. Then all you need to do is fill in the floor again with your wooden planks, like this. So it's pretty easy, exactly the same as we were doing with the other ones. Just fill in the floor, and I'm not there. Then again, put your cobblestone slabs on the outside of all of these blocks like this. And across the back, I think I put it across the back as well. Yep, so I put it across the back as well. What you're also going to do, across the front, take out these three slabs here, and you're going to put in stairs, and this part will be a full block. It's just to make it like a raised kind of front deck type thing. Well, it's not really a deck, it's too small for that. And these two slabs switch out for cobblestone walls. And this one, make a full block. On top of this, you're going to build a gun, so you've got a fence. And then you've got a fence gate as well. So that's how I just did the front gun for it. And now we need to build a canopy over the top of it. Okay, for the canopy on this part, what we're going to do is come to the back of it and come up and make this a full block here. Then have a stair on it. You're going to join these across here. Then you have five slabs, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and that's where your next full block and stair is going to go. So same on the other side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And you got a full block on the bottom and a stair that connects in. And you got three coming across here, and then fill in the roof like this. So then you've got this kind of canopy, and you can actually go down underneath it as well. I did put in some seats. I think they're kind of roughly done like this, but you could also put them in just on the inside if you wanted to. It's kind of up to you what you want to do with these parts. They're not the best seats in the world. Yeah, you would have to use the slabs, unfortunately. The other thing you can do, of course, is you can build this if you want to with the entire deck, have the outside with the stairs and wrap those around. But on mine, I've just got it pretty simply because you know, you've got this massive ship around it, and we've just got a little bit of detail to do, and that's it. Okay, I just double-checked the seats on mine. If you want exactly the same, I've just joined these up, so I kind of made a bench instead, so it's got two benches on the sides. There's a tiny little sensor on this one, so near the back, come into the middle, and come in by one block gap. So you've got this one block gap here, put a piece of black wall on it, and it's just got a shed load of buttons around it, just like this. There's also, on these side parts, just a button on the side of these kind of full blocks that you've got, just like that. And that finishes off all of the small boats. Well done on completing the Tegetthoff-class battleship. Hopefully you guys have really enjoyed yourself with this build. It was a really interesting one for me to actually do from scratch, as there's, you know, a lot of black and white pictures, but I did rely heavily on people that have made small models of it. So this is mainly built on the kind of Tegetthoff-class. The SMS Szent István is slightly different, and when I get around to part 2, I am going to show you how to do it. The Szent István itself didn't actually have four propellers, it had two of them, so you can just cut out one of those, two of those instead. And there's just a couple of bits that's connected on, but I will do it in part 2, which will be probably a week after this tutorial comes out, just because I've been so busy at the minute. And I still need to do the Type 45 destroyer part 2. So yeah, make sure that you kind of, you know, pat yourself on the back for completing this one. It is a big build. Just remember to comment, like, and subscribe, and I will see you guys on the next big tutorial.